Hello, my name is June Holloman, and in this video, you'll learn how to access and navigate around eLearning that allows your students to complete online assessments and activities, as well as allow you to add online content, calculate and post grades. To start, go to the UTD main webpage, select Resources, and then the eLearning link for the login page. Here, enter your NetID and password. If you cannot remember your password, select Reset Your Password. If you have other issues, select Contact the Help Desk. Be sure to complete the due confirmation if prompted. As a first-time user, you will see a short explanation about eLearning features before and after you join eLearning. Upon login, you see the base navigation, a launching point for accessing your courses, organizations, various communications, and additional campus resources. The landing page, the first page you see, is the institution page that provides campus posts and helpful information, such as OIT and eLearning help, tutorials, as well as modules for student, faculty, and campus resources. But students can find additional resources with the Assist tab. You can communicate with your students by using messages. Just click on the course to post or read messages. Please note that this communication remains inside of eLearning. UTD emails are a different command. To return to the base navigation, just select the Close tab on the left. Another way to communicate with students is with the Calendar tab, as it automatically posts due dates and allows you to post online office hours with a link. By default, you can review all alerts for navigation and course activities from the activity stream. These alerts also appear with a daily email digest, so you do not necessarily have to go into your eLearning screen. If you want to adjust the alerts, then you can select Settings, or go to your Profile tab and edit alerts from the section Global Notification Settings. Note that you have other profile options. You can record how to pronounce your name with Add Pronunciation. Anytime the pencil icon appears, you can also edit a setting. So when I move my mouse to my profile, you can see that I have the option to add a photo or image that appears whenever I directly engage with a class or eLearning organization. For example, discussion boards or Blackboard Collaborate. Speaking of courses, all the courses you teach or take are located in the Courses tab. If your view looks different from mine, note that you can change the layout by selecting the Layout button on the left to toggle between List and Tile View. By default, you see all current courses you're teaching or taking, but you can change the view by selecting current course title for a different list. You can rearrange your course list by pinning the courses you visit frequently to the top by selecting their star. You can shorten the list by using Hide Courses. Just select the Option button, represented by three dots, and then select Hide Course. To display a hidden course, go to the drop-down list for filter, select Hidden for Me, and then select the Option button command to use Show Course. Note, these same options are available for organizations if you're an org leader. However, participants like students are not allowed to hide courses. Organizations and courses have the same tool options, but organizations are not FERPA protected and can run shorter or longer than actual courses. This is because courses are tied to the registrar's office and therefore follow the academic calendar. The last two links on the bottom are tools for students to use the portfolio tool option and the sign out command. Now that you know about the eLearning space navigation, we can review how to set up your course in part two. For more information about eLearning, you can also contact us with eLearning@utdallas.edu.